Hello, I'm Grace Farrell, and this is Midweek Geek. Now, this week, everyone has been talking about Fox's new post-apocalyptic TV series, The Last Man on Earth. So we're going to do a little review of that and then tell you what we've got coming up in the next few weeks. Created by funny man Will Forte, The Last Man on Earth has turned the apocalypse genre on its head by taking a comedic perspective on an Earth that's been ravaged by a deadly virus. It stars Forte as Phil Miller, an office temp living in Tucson, Arizona, who seems to be the only survivor. The pilot follows Phil as he uses the lack of other humans and laws to his advantage. He moves into a mansion and decks it out with historical masterpieces. He raids the supermarket and drinks a $10,000 bottle of wine topped with whipped cream. We won't give you any spoilers other than what's good, what's great, and what maybe doesn't work. So what's good? The soundtrack. It's just 60s rock galore. And Forte is protagonist Phil Miller. He's hilarious, but still somewhat believable. And although he does start to go insane, it's with a sort of lovable sincerity. What's great? The premise. It's not just another post-apocalyptic TV show. It's original and bloody funny. It explores a whole new side of the apocalypse that we've never really seen on TV before. What maybe doesn't work? Well, we'll have to wait and see. With such a narrow cast and premise, it is difficult to confidently predict how the series will hold up going forward, but after such a great pilot, it's surely worth an investment. The Last Man on Earth seems a perfect excuse to kick off our apocalypse season here at the 86th Floor. We're scouring the UK to put together a definitive manual of zombie escape tactics for any eventuality and any personality. And it's not just us going mad over the apocalypse at the moment. 2015 is set to be crazy for the genre. Mad Max Fury Road is set for release in May. Terminator Genesis will follow in July. And The Walking Dead will reach its grisly finale in just a few weeks, as well as sci-fi's 12 Monkeys and the second season of The 100. Also set to return this year are The Last Ship, Falling Skies, Under the Dome, Z Nation, and Defiance. Plus, my personal favourite, The Leftovers. Don't forget to subscribe for more apocalypse-related reviews and videos.